Students, in case of amplifier, it has two inputs, AC input as well as DC input. So, while analyzing, if we analyze the circuit only for DC input, then it is called as DC analysis. If we have only AC input, then it is called as AC analysis. But how to do that? Yes, we can do that because we know that there is something called as superposition theorem. It states that if there are multiple sources available in the circuit, you can treat one source at a time. Hence, when there are AC as well as DC applied, what I am going to do is, while performing DC analysis, we will consider only DC source, where AC is absent. Hence, circuit diagram for DC circuit becomes which has VCC, which is DC battery, RC, RB, and again DC battery called as VBB. As shown in the circuit diagram, a DC battery is applied at the base and at the collector. The voltage between collector to emitter is called as VCE, and voltage between base to emitter is called as VBE. In order to get DC load line, we need to apply KVL to the output. Before that, what is exactly DC load line? DC load line is a graph which has all possible values of IC and VCE. I repeat, DC load line is a graph which has all possible values of output current IC and output voltage VC. So apply KVL to the output, we will get equation as VCC minus current flowing from collector, that is IC, multiplied by RC minus VCE is equal to 0. So equation becomes VCC minus IC into RC minus VCE is equal to 0. Hence, we can write IC into RC is equal to minus VCE plus VCC. Hence, IC is equal to minus 1 by RC into VCE plus VCC divided by RC. So we have got equation of IC. In order to draw a line, we required minimum 2 points. How to get these 2 points? That is a question in our mind. So what we can do is, to get value of IC, I can put VCE is equal to 0. And to get value of VCE, we can put IC is equal to 0. Thus, we can have 2 points to draw a load line. Case 1, put IC is equal to 0. When IC is equal to 0, VCE becomes equal to VCC. This is point A. If we put VCE is equal to 0, then we'll get IC is equal to VCC by RC. That is point B. So we have got point A and point B. So we can easily draw a DC load line in output characteristics. This is very interesting. The DC load line is graph of all values of IC and VCE. For common emitter configuration, IC and VCE will be on output characteristics. That's why DC load line is drawn at output characteristics. So we will plot DC load line for which A point and B point we have already calculated. Whereas this is called as IC and this is VCE. If we plot point A and B, we will get this as DC load line. This is VCE is equal to VCC, that is point A, and this is VCC divided by RC point A, and this is called as DC load line. Now what we can do is we can get something called as operating point Q. Operating point Q is defined as, it is a point for a particular value of IC and for corresponding value of VCE. What we can do is we can select Q point at exactly at the middle of the load line. When output characteristics intersect DC load line, we can get different Q points. But for faithful amplification, we'll going to select Q point at exactly middle of the load line as shown in the diagram. This is how we can plot DC load line and we can get operating point at the center of the load line. Thank you.